joined by the president of the North Ridgeville Travel Basketball Association, Mr. Ron Boynar. Thank you so much for being here at halftime.
Happy to be here, Dave.
So for anybody who may not know, explain what the Travel Basketball Association is and does.
Yes, we're the North Ridgeville Travel Basketball Association. So we're a travel program for the city. You can consider us the grade school teams, right? So boys and girls, grades third through sixth. And we fit right between the rec program and AAU, right? So the rec program, you know, if you look at North Ridgeville Travel Basketball, we're competitive in nature, so we're performance-based. We have tryouts, and we form teams, and we get after it. So we're in the North Coast Travel Basketball League, and, you know, the league's finishing up right now. We have teams in the playoffs. It's exciting stuff.
So you're playing against other cities from around here, or who? What are the teams that you're playing against?
Yeah, so a lot of the same cities you see in our conference, right? So you got Amherst and Olmsted and Avon Lac. All those schools are in the league, right? And so the whole idea behind the program we built is we wanted to develop a program where our kids are playing against those same teams, and we're feeding the high school with good talent that can compete in the conference. And you know that's what we started to develop.
So you're the president, but who are some of the people that help you, and can people still get involved?
Yeah, you know, I got to give credit to Tim O'Quintana. He started the program over 10 years ago, right? And back then it was get some teams together, put them in a league. And then a bunch of parents got together 3-4 years ago and wanted to see more of a program approach and see this team develop. You know, we have the facilities, we have the kids, we have the parents who want a championship program, right? And so that's what we were trying to develop. But people like Quentin Putt, Bob Schneider, Dave Baker, you know, Jason, all these guys and girls, Julie Arnold, Angie Mack, I'm going to forget people, Kimmy Corrigan, all put a ton of time into building this program over the past few years. And, you know, that's who we really need to thank.
So it's a lot of parent volunteers that help keep this going.
Completely volunteer program. So right now we're running 12 teams, two teams per grade by design. We want to feed the middle school who has two teams. So two teams on the boys' side, one on the girls' side. So we're talking 22 coaches, 109 players, and, you know, and only, unfortunately, only a few board members who are really making this thing go. And so that's what we could use the most, more volunteers to help run the program.
Yeah, and so you do need a lot of help in a lot of different aspects.
We do, and you know, we take a small break summertime, you know, from organizing, but then we got to get after it because tryouts are in September. The only way we're going to build a championship program is if we outwork the other communities. So we have to have summer programming, skill development. Big thanks to Hoop Tech, Dan and Samantha, over at Hoop Tech. You know, if it wasn't for them this year, I'm not sure we might have had a program this year because we depend on the school for our facilities. And that wasn't there this year, so Hoop Tech came through. If you haven't been over at Hoop Tech, awesome place, go check it out. But they were a big help, and so we're planning on, Coach Chase runs fundamental skill training, planning on doing it over at Hoop Tech and some other things going on over there, just so our kids can catch up to some of the other schools around us.
Well, you mentioned how COVID took away your facilities. It also took away one of the treats here normally at the high school boys games. Everybody loves the donuts that the kids sell. The kids come out and sell donuts. Talk about that.
They do. Yeah, we started a donut fundraiser a couple years ago. So we had the teams come out and walk the crowd selling donuts. And people love them. I miss the donuts. Can't do it this year, but we'll get back after it next year. You know, the part of the program is you get to be part of the high school program. You get to be on the court for the national anthem. You get to be in the locker room with the team as the coach is, you know, talking about the game plan. You get to go to Cleveland State to watch a game and play on the court. You get to play on this court. You get to be part of all those things and being part of this travel program and just being involved in the school. That's what I love most about it, is just the community involvement, and it's really something special. But I tell you, Dave, watch out, because our kids, you know, a few years ago, we were about 25% winning percentage. We are now winning more games than we're not. Our fifth grade girls, shout out to them, 11-1. Our boys' third grade team is 10-2. We're winning games, and it's starting at the lower level. So six, 7 years from now, I mean, look at the eighth grade team. Those boys were in North NRTBA. You know, they're lights out. So it's coming.
So how can people get involved and sign their kids up?
Yeah, so check us out on NRTBA Facebook. Reach out to me, reach out to Angie. We'll get you involved. We need people to make this thing go. That's what we absolutely need. But reach out to us either way. Either, you know, give me a call or whatever you want to do. We'll get you involved.
You do a great job. We appreciate so much you do for the young kids in the community. Ron Boyner, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks, Dave. Appreciate it.